say it again.
I want to take this moment, but it is how you respond. It is your understanding of what you are going through and your response to it. Your reaction to it. That then begin to determine your outlook after that situation.
God hasn't promised us an easy journey.
God didn't promise us that we will not face problems and
situations.
In fact, as we are living in this corrupt world, the Bible calls this world, it calls the devil the god of this world. And that tells me that the god of this world that we are currently living in is the devil. That's why the Bible says we are in this world, but we are not of this world. Now when the Bible says the god of this world is the devil, he said the one who's influencing the world is the
devil.
Now it means if this world is being influenced and manipulated by the devil, then there is corruption working in this world. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if he is the father of corruption and is influencing and manipulating this world, it means therefore you might as well expect some problems in this world.
Nangabe Satane angibabe walomhlaba futhi athela umonakalo kulomhlaba funa kanjalo ngathi tingcinamba letiyakwehlela.
You might expect that there are going to be some bumps, there are going to be some things that are going to happen. And those challenges, they happen to all of us. But now it is how we respond. Because now all of us, we are in this world. But not all of us are of this world. So if all of us are in this world, it means all of us, we go to the challenges of this world. But what differentiates us from everyone else? Number one, it is that as we are not of this world. Number two, it is that as we have understanding, when we face through things in this world, our understanding gives us the know-how how to respond. Because it is how we respond to these things that determines how we're going to come out at the end of the
time.
So the whole world is undergoing a turmoil. The whole world, everyone is talking about
COVID-19.
Everyone is scared. Everyone is uncertain.
Everyone is weakened.
But the biggest problem is not that everyone is scared. The biggest problem is that even the children of God who are not of this world are scared like the people of this world. So permit me today to bring an encouragement to you. And bring an understanding to you of how we should respond as
children. 1 Timothy 1:18.
Speaking here, it is Paul is speaking to Timothy. He says to Timothy, this church I commit to you, son Timothy. I didn't come to preach about this, but let me just take a side turn and talk about this. Good God. People that are going to be saved in this time are people that have fathers in the Lord. When they don't know what to do, their father can give them a charge. Their fathers can give them an instruction from the Lord. In this season, you don't need to be a vagabond. You need to have a father. A father that will shepherd you, that will help you navigate. There are too many information going
on
that are causing to be in fear.
The children of God,
but right now you need to close your ears. If you go to WhatsApp, there are
change
messages that are saying people are dying. When you open your television, news are talking negative. It is this season that you need to
call.
You need to close your ears and say, I know that I have a father. I am going to wait and hear what my father
is
saying. I'm going to follow what Dr. NM is saying. And as he released that word of instruction, the word of instruction from your father that will begin to guide you, that will begin to help you navigate this life, this challenging situation. You need to hearken. You live in this season, don't allow anything to pollute your conscience. What you need in this season, and when I'm talking about a good conscience, I'm not talking about nebesa, just putting, I'm not feeling guilty.
No.
Here I'm talking about you being careful. Watching. What comes to you? Peter says, guide the loins of your mind.
Guide.
The loins of your mind. It means in this season, you need to watch what is coming into your mind. What is getting into your soulish mind. The loins of your mind. Why? Because you want to hold on to a good conscience. Why? Because it is everything. It is everything. In how you are going to respond. Because how you respond.
Will
determine how you will look like when you come out of this
school.
Paul says to Timothy, Timothy, hold on,
Bambisisa,
Fight a good fight of
faith.
Using the prophecies that were
spoken. Using the prophetic
word that were released on you.
You might
be saying, Pastor Peter, but there is no prophecy upon my life.
Apostle Peter, but there was prophet to a
below. I have come to tell you that there is a prophecy upon my life. The promises of God.
Let
the
terms of the
Lord. Yes and amen. In Christ Jesus.
Christ to Jesus.
If a man be in Christ. If a man be in Christ. If you are born again. You are in Christ.
Christ.
And if you are in Christ. The promises of God.
The terms
of the Lord. The promises of God upon your life. So you do have prophecies. You do have prophecies. The promises that God promises us. They are yours. And in this season, they are the ones you need to fight. To war.
But
watch this.
But watch this.
Watch this. He says. Fight
Luani.
A good
Gulwa
fight
Luani.
Of faith.
Gula Lobushe will call.
Fight
Luani.
A good fight.
Gula Lobushe.
That means
Loshobuzi.
You can fight.
Ungalwa.
But not a good fight.
Let me tell you
something. One of the things that is guaranteed in life is battles.
We are in it right
now. The whole
world is
fighting
for his life.
But watch this, there is a principle in scripture. In
2 Corinthians 3:18.
It says, as we behold. As we behold, we become. This is the principle. This is the principle.
Hallelujah.
This is the principle. You become what you behold. That's why you need a father in this season. Because the word he's going to release. The word he's going to behold. Your father is what you are going to become irregardless. So watch this. Everyone is fighting. But this is a question I want to ask
you.
This is a question I want to ask you as I close. Which fight are you fighting? How are you fighting? There's a good fight. That's prescribed for the children of God. And there's a fight that everyone is fighting. You can fight demons. It's not wrong to cast out demons. But the believer is not called to fight demons.
Hallelujah.
You can fight curses. But the believer is not called to fight curses.
God, umzalwane nomuKristu akabikelwa ukulwa nedicalenis.
Yes. But Pastor Pinda, there is a curse in my life.
God, I'm full of spirit. I'm not scared.
Yes, but there are demons manifesting in my life.
Yebo, kune madimoni ndikhombakalisa.
Yes, Pastor Pinda, there is coronavirus.
Yebo, Pastor Pinda, kuna nayo coronavirus.
I am not denying that.
Angwali lo.
But what I'm saying.
God,
what you are fighting, by the end of the fight, you will look like what you are fighting. Have you ever seen these people that likes to go to deliverance? You don't even ask them. He's busy with deliverance. He's busy with casting demons. Why? He looks like what he is fighting.
Have you seen somebody who doesn't have
money?
Have you seen somebody who is sick?
All the time some point,
yes, he's fighting.
But he's fighting wrong. That's why now he is looking like what he is fighting. That's why Paul said that. He said, listen, there are many fights. But you,
God,
you are born again. You are a believer.
Hallelujah.
I cast out demons myself.
But I'm saying
we are not called to fight. We are not even called to fight corona. We are called to fight a good fight of faith. What is the good fight of faith? It is to believe the things that God has declared
and
promised
and
fulfilled in the cross of Jesus Christ. In this season, you don't need to be afraid. Jesus said, fear not. Said, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you.
Amen.
It is a promise for everyone. That is in Christ Jesus.
Jesus.
When fear comes, when news comes, when bad news comes,
it is
time to hold on
to
the promises of God. And say, Peter, I will not be afraid. I may not feel anything. But Jehovah
has
promised me he will never leave me. He will never leave me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's the time to believe what God has promised us. If you don't know the promises of God, go into the script.
It's time to dig.
Find every promise of God. Search for the promises of God. And hold on. Believe on them.
Call on
prophesy.
Prophet.
Declare them in your life. In this season, when you get into prayer, it's not time to pray about sickness. It's not time to pray about
fire.
It's time to speak into your life. Hey, when others are saying, hey, finances are not going
well.
When they are saying, we are going down. When they are saying, they are not peaceful. When they are not tight. You get into your prayer
night
and send my provision. My provision doesn't come from the economy of Swaziland. It doesn't come from the economy of this world. But there is a promise on my life.
It became
poor.
When do I wish well?
It became poor.
When do I wish well?
So that I may be rich. That is a promise on my life. And you take that promise. And you go into God. And you catch it. You say, God, in this season, I will not suffer. I will not care. Because there is a promise in my life. He became poor so that I may be rich. Not to be rich when things are going
on.
No. The promise, this is the power of the promises of God. The promises of God doesn't depend on the natural.
The promises of God doesn't depend on the natural.
This season needs people that are going to move.
Labatanya
from from the natural and step up into the supernatural and the bridge and the bridge is faith. It's a fight of faith. It's a fight of faith. The Bible says
labor.
That is the only labor we need to do in this season. It is to labor. To enter rest. What is the rest? It is believing that 2,000 years ago, Jesus, who was God, became man to make me to become God. Now, as he is, so I am. So can I ask you this question as I can? Can Jesus be affected by virus? Can God be affected by virus? I know you are already positive. You are already affected. And you all hope is gone. And you are saying, what about me? I
want
to leave you with this question. Can God be killed by virus? If God cannot be killed by virus, His children, they cannot be killed by virus. So in this season, I'm holding on to that. And as you hold on to that, you've got the promise of God. They are going to pull you out from the natural. In the natural.
And that way.
People that are affected by virus. They die. But in the supernatural, people that are affected by virus, they kill
virus.
And I've come to prophesy to you. I've come to awaken the children of God. We are not going to be affected by virus. But our prayers, our faith in this season is affecting every virus.
It's
killing every virus. It's stopping every virus. In the name of Jesus.
The challenge of this time, where possible losing leader Kulukulu Raja, a question, I remain standing. But possible losing leader Kulukulu Raja, perhaps from your Lord, now perhaps from your Lord. Shows my entire life. If God goes, I go. Nicodemus Bazala. Uti Paula lean such that on God. In other words,
every
other human, medical, or whatever you support, remove your way from those things. No, we need these things. We need a matter, we need a doctor, we need all this. But if I rest, I na doctor. If I rest, I na which doctor. If I rest, I na my short. If I rest, I na mundane mali, I na gym, I na spunziswa. You can't lean on your education, you can't lean on your doctor, you can't lean on your entire life. If God goes, you go.
Hallelujah.
Let's take this home. If God goes, the day God dies, you die. If God continues to live, you live. If God stands, you stand. If He falls, you fall. But our God is the same, yesterday, today, forever. Blessed Redeemer. Look. It is not even very easy. Okay, look at this.
Senago, we give you glory, we give you honor. So, Kulumina Gossi, Muban Lumianus Apitis in Lalele, Nasabu Kumewena, Shiabo Ababe, Uskubota, Gogotsi, Sifanen and Gossi, Weluswa, Nega Maligaches, who crushed Mobadi Vlakulias Kobisata Vite, elusile hlani but uthe elusile David naye abelusiwe engakho kwasina khamba libhele nelibubese wakhona ubhekana nalo ngoba emandla wawathola kulomelusi lobekadza melusi babe lungcwele siyabonga uNkulunkulu wethembekile njengoba sokukhulumile ngale ndlela wasiphakamisa emoyeni chubeka uNkulunkulu uphakamise ibandla lakho ngegama lika Jesu Christ waseNazaretha sesivile babe ukuthi thine angeke siqwile kodwa babe kulesimo sitawuhamba tukwaso ngegama nangengathi ya Jesu Christ waseNazaretha qhubeka babe usole ngoba uNkulunkulu nakude loselusile sitawuhamba kalufifi ngeke sabone mbili ngegama lika Jesu Christ. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we give you glory in Jesus mighty name. Amen.
Come on.